yesterday we have studied that there are two methods of connection of a three phase system. First method is star connection, second method is delta connection. Three phases are connected in star and delta. This is one phase, Zph. I have written Z. Z for impedance, impedance per phase, Zph. This is one phase, this is second phase, and this is third phase. So three phases are connected in star. Here three phases are connected in delta. So this line to this point, that is known as one phase. This line to this point, second phase. This line to this point, third phase. This is neutral point. So a phase is connected between line and neutral. Phase is connected between line and neutral. So from line to neutral, this voltage, voltage of red phase, phase voltage, voltage of red phase, that is phase voltage, Vy, Vb, three phase voltages, line to neutral, Vr, red phase, line to neutral, Vy, Y phase, line to neutral, Vb, blue phase. So Vr, Vy, Vb, all are phase voltages. Voltage between red line and yellow line, that is known as line voltage. Red and yellow, so Vr1. Vr minus Vy. Potential difference of two phase voltages. Vr, Y. Vr minus Vy. Vyb. Vy minus Vb. First one is at higher potential, second one is at lower potential. And then Vbr. Vb minus Vr. So three line voltages. Vry. Vector difference of red phase voltage and yellow phase voltage. Vyb, another line voltage. Vector difference of Y phase voltage and B phase voltage. Vbr. Vector difference of blue phase voltage and red phase voltage. I have already told you that all the quantities are vector quantities. Now, this is the current flowing through this phase. Iph, phase current. It is going through red phase. So, Iph is equal to IR. The same current is entering this line. So, same IR is entering this line. So, you can call it as IL or Iph. The current going through phase is also passing through line. Same current. So, line current is equal to phase current. But line voltage is not equal to phase voltage. Line voltage is not equal to phase voltage. So here we have to derive the relation between line voltage and phase voltage. So our aim is to derive the relation between line voltage and phase voltage, while line current and phase current are same. To that said, it is different. This phase is connected between two lines. So voltage across this phase is also voltage across the lines. Voltage across this phase is also voltage across the line. So line voltage is equal to phase voltage. Here line current is equal to phase current. Here line voltage is equal to phase voltage. Now current flowing through this phase is IR up to this node. Current passing through this is IB. So what will be current in this line? IR is entering, IB is leaving. Their vector difference. IR minus IB, written as IRB. VRY, VR minus VY. Similarly, IRB, IR minus IB. The first letter is at higher potential, second one is at lower potential. So IR minus IB. So at this node, IB is entering and IY is leaving. So that is IB is entering, IY is leaving, so current will be IBY. IB entering, IY leaving. To this node, IY is entering, IR is leaving. So IYR, IYR, IY minus IR. IRB, IR, line current, vector difference of phase currents. So line current is not equal to phase current, but line voltage is equal to phase voltage. Here line current is equal to phase current. So here we have to derive the relation between line current and phase current. So in star we have to derive the relation between line voltage and phase voltage. In delta we have to derive the relation between line current and phase current. Right? So these derivations, either this one or this one, may be asked in the exam for 6 marks. So here, what is the relation between line voltage VL and phase voltage VPH? That we have to derive. Here, what is the relation between line current IL and phase current IPH? That we have to derive. So derivation is very simple, but vector diagram, we have to draw the vector diagram for this. Now, how to draw the vector diagram? Listen to it very carefully. So first, I am starting the derivation now. Let VR is equal to VY, is equal to VB, is equal to VPH. VR, VY, VB, all are phase voltages. So VR is equal to VY, is equal to VB, is equal to phase voltages. VRY, R minus Y. VYB, VY minus VB. And VBR, all are line voltages. VRY, VYB and VBR are line voltages. Similarly to that set. Line current and phase current are same. Here line voltage and phase voltage are same. Now line current. Let whatever I have written here for voltages, same I will write there for currents. IR is equal to IY is equal to IB is equal to phase currents. Here voltages equal to phase voltages, here currents equal to phase currents. Here line voltages I have written, here line currents IRB, IYR, IBY. First IRB. This minus this. Second is IYR. This minus this. And third is IBY. All are line currents. IRB, IYB, IYR and IBY are line currents. So our aim is to derive a relation between this and this. Relation between this and this. For that purpose we have to draw the vector diagram. Now this ZPH, impedance per phase, Z, you have studied it in first year, impedance. Z consists of resistor along with inductor, resistor along with capacitor, or resistor along with inductor and capacitor both. So what is impedance? Impedance is combination of resistor and inductor, resistor and capacitor, or resistor and inductor and capacitor. So this Z in both cases may consist of R, L, R, C or R, L, C. Is that clear? So now I will draw the vector diagram for both and then we will derive the relation. First I will draw the vector diagram of star. Then I will draw the vector diagram of delta. You need to draw the vector diagram very, very carefully. So now see. How to draw the vector diagram? I have drawn three vectors. VR, phase voltage, VY, phase voltage, VB, phase voltage. 120 degree apart from each other. This one, 120 degree lagging VY, 120 degree lagging VB. Is that clear? You have to draw three vectors, VR, that is phase voltage, VY, VB. VY lagging VR by 120 degree. Yesterday I told you. And VB lagging VY by 120 degree. Right? Then extend each vector in negative direction. All the three lengths are similar. All the three lengths are similar. 120 degree, 120 degree. Right? Now extend each vector in negative direction. Minus VR. Same length in negative direction. Minus VB. Minus VR. Right? Now VRY. Vector difference of R and Y. R positive, Y negative. Their vector difference is VRY. R positive, Y negative. Where is the combination? R positive, Y negative. Right? I will complete parallelogram of these two. Draw parallel line of this here. And parallel line of this here. R positive, Y negative. I am completing their parallelogram. Parallel line of this on this, parallel line of this on this, and then join this. This is VRY. VRY is vector difference of R and Y. How we have to plot? R positive, Y negative combination, and complete the parallelogram. The diagonal is VRY. VYB, Y positive, B negative. Y positive, B negative. Complete the parallelogram. Parallel line. VBR, B positive, R negative. B positive, R negative. This is the vector diagram. Right? If it is drawn with proper scale, all the parallelograms will be similar. This is little bit short. It is not drawn with proper scale, but you will have to draw it with proper scale. Same length, same length, same length. Extend everyone in negative direction. And then VRY, R positive, Y negative. Complete the parallelogram. R positive, Y negative. Y positive, B negative. Y positive, B negative. And B positive, R negative. Right? So this angle will be 60 degree. Okay. Now, in mathematics, you have studied law of a parallelogram. Law of parallelogram. This is a parallelogram. What is that law? Diagonal square. Diagonal square. Law of parallelogram. Diagonal square is equal to side squares. This side square plus this side square minus 2 times product of sides. Minus 2 times VR into minus VY. Cos of angle between them. Angle between them is 60 degrees. This is law of parallelogram. Diagonal square. You can write the equation either for this, or for this. Any one. Right? So VRY square, R square plus minus VR square minus 2 times both product of both the sides. Positive VR minus VY and cos of angle between them. This is equal to VR square plus VY square plus minus minus plus 2 VR into VY into cos of 60 is 1 by 3. Is that clear? Now, in place of VRY, I will write VN. And in place of VR, VY, VB, I will write VPH. In place of VRY, VN, in place of VR is equal to VY is equal to VB is equal to VPH. VR VY. VR VY. For both, I will write VPH. VL square is equal to VPH square plus VPH square. 2 times, both are VPH. Sorry, 2 to cancel plus VPH square. So VL square is equal to 3 VPH square. So VL is equal to 2 VPH. Relation between line voltage and phase voltage. Relation between line voltage and phase voltage. Right? Got it? Same way, this is cool. IRB square. Now I am directly writing the equation. We have to draw the vector diagram for current to this side. Now I am writing the equation. In place of VRY, I will write IRB. In place of VR, I will write IR. In place of VY, I will write IB. And vector diagram, in place of voltage, we have to draw the vector diagram for current. I am writing parallelogram, the law of parallelogram. IRB square is equal to, for this, IR square plus minus IB square minus 2 IR minus IB cos of 60. Two cancel, cos of 60 is 1 by 2. In place of IRB, I will write IL, and in place of IR, IY, IB, I will write IPH. IL, IPH, 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 IPH. Is that clear? So in star, IL is equal to IPH, VL is equal to root 3 VPH. Exactly opposite in delta. VL is equal to VPH and IL is equal to root 3 IPH. Is that clear? Okay. Pause for now. Or this derivation may be asked in the exam. So in star, IL is equal to IPH, in delta, VL is equal to VPH. In star, VL is equal to root 3 VPH. In delta, IL is equal to root 3 VPH. Now power, active power. VPH, IPH, cos of phi. In first year, we have studied AC power VI cos phi. So, active power. Phase voltage, phase current into cos of phi. Power of one phase. But we are studying three-phase circuits. So this is multiplied by 3. Power of single phase is single phase voltage, single phase current, cos of phi. Power factor. Cos of phi is known as power factor. For three-phase, it is multiplied by 3. Here also. Right? Is equal to 3 into VPH will be VL by root 3. VPH will be VL upon root 3. And IPH is equal to IL. VPH is equal to VL upon root 3. IPH is equal to IL. I am replacing. Here, VPH is equal to VL. Right? So, P active root 3 VL IL. Cos phi. Here also P active root 3 VL IL cos phi. Where cos phi is power factor. Similarly, reactive power root 3 VL IL sin phi. Sin phi is the reactive component. Reactive power. Root 3 VL IL sin phi. And finally, apparent power. Root 3 VL IL. So these three powers. Apparent power, Pythagoras. This is diagonal. I will show you. You might have studied it in first year. Power triangle. Apparent power. Active power. Reactive power. This is angle phi. This square is equal to this square plus this square. This square is equal to this square plus this square. Sin square phi plus cos square phi will be 1 root 3 VL IL. Apparent power. Pythagoras. This square is equal to this square plus this square. Right? So this square plus this square. This square plus this square. Cos square phi plus sin square phi. This is common. So in bracket there will be sin square phi plus cos square phi. It is 1. So root 3 VL IL. So that side also it is same. So this is about relation between line voltage, line current, phase current of star and delta, and then active power, reactive power, apparent power. And now in the next lecture we have to study numerical on these. Numericals are very easy. I will give you the steps, formulae. So go on using those steps, the problem will be solved. Right? It will be observed in next lecture. Okay, thank you.